All right, in this video we're going to do some examples of going from basically our polar form back to our complex form. So a couple examples here, and I think these are certainly a little bit easier to do than putting them into polar form, because really all you have to do is just kind of do the arithmetic. So part A here, we've got 3 times cosine of 135 degrees. Well, 135 degrees is going to be in quadrant 2. Cosine of 135 degrees is negative square root of 2 over 2. Sine of 135 degrees is positive square root of 2 over 2. So now all we have to do is just distribute out the 3, so we'll get negative 3 root 2 over 2 plus 3 root 2 over 2. I'm going to stick my I out to the right side. And now we've taken our number that was in our polar number and put it in complex form. So that's all there is to do. You really just have to evaluate whatever cosine of the angle is, whatever the sine of the angle is, and just multiply it out. So we can do our other example here, I think, real quick as well. So let's see, 270 degrees. If you think about 270 degrees, well, 270 degrees is just going to put us at the negative y-axis. And well, cosine of 270 degrees, the x-coordinate on the unit circle there would be 0. Sine of 270 degrees, that would be the value of the y-coordinate on the unit circle, which would just be negative 1. Well, if we distribute 4 times 0, we'll get 0. A positive 4 times a negative 1 will be negative 4i. So typically, we'll just write it as negative 4i. We could write it as 0 minus 4i if you also want to see the real part. But that's all there is to it. Again, just simply evaluate cosine of the angle, sine of the angle, distribute it out. In this case, there wasn't a lot to cancel or simplify. But if there was, that would be all you'd have to do, and you would get your solution.